Effect of daytime naps. Sleep is inevitable both in memory formation and the consolidation of new information. New technologies help scientists to see where in the brain learning takes place, and how sleep deprivation interferes with the brain's neuroplasticity. Neuroplasticity is the brain's ability to respond and adapt to the stimuli it receives from the environment. What happens under the hood when we are asleep has also been the focus of numerous studies. According to research, scientists were able to locate specific memories and strengthen them while the study participants were asleep using certain auditory cues. Now, an intriguing new study focuses on the effect of daytime naps on the brain's ability to process information that we are not consciously aware of. A study, on 23 July 2018, published in the Journal of Sleep Research, examines the effects of short naps on the brain's ability to process unconscious information. Additionally, the study examined how daytime naps impact conscious behavior and choice reaction time, the speed with which the brain processes new information. Liz Coulthard, a consultant senior lecturer in dementia neurology at the University of Bristol Medical School in the United Kingdom, led the new research. The researchers measured the participants' choice reaction time and brain activity both before and after the nap using electroencephalogram. The study found that naps specifically aid the processing of information that was acquired unconsciously. Even a short period of sleep may help process information, improve reaction times, and potentially influence the behavior of the person when awake. These findings strengthen the idea that the information perceived unconsciously is processed during sleep, and that sleep may aid in decision-making when awake. The findings are remarkable in that they can occur in the absence of initial intentional, conscious awareness, by processing of implicitly presented cues beneath participants' conscious awareness. The researchers plan to undertake more work in the future to compare if and how the findings differ between ages, and investigation of underlying neural mechanisms. Thank you.